Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator Advanced course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Also, there's a link in the description for the exercise files. Those are free to download, so go and download those. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there, in this video we're going to make this paper cut effect using Adobe Illustrator. Alright, let's jump in and do it. Alright, to start making this effect we are going to use a bit of type. The one thing also, we're going to use some colors that are from the 80s. You saw at the beginning there, so just make sure your document setup or document color mode is RGB. You just can't reach those colors with CMYK. So grab the type tool, create a letter. I'm just going to use the letter X like you saw, and I'm going to use a nice big thick font. Okay, so I'm going to use Museo Slab. It's part of Typekit. You can download that for free as part of your license. If you don't have Museo, you can just go into here and go Slab Serif and just see what slabs you have on here. Okay, I feel like I have more than that, but anyway, let's go for super chunky, even chunkier, 1000. All right, I'm going to make them nice and big, and I am going to outline it. Okay, you need to outline the font eventually. I'm going to make a copy over here. We've all done it right. You outline it, and you can't remember what it was. So this guy here is going to be outlined. So type, create outlines. And now we're going to do some drawing. Okay, so up to you. You can be super precise with the curvature or pen tool. I am not. I'm going to use the pencil tool. But just make sure that I've double-clicked the pencil tool, your smoothing is up really high, and you've unselected keep selected. That just causes a pain while you're drawing. One thing I wish though, I wish I had my Wacom tablet with me. Again, I'm stuck inside with a snowstorm. Okay, so we're filming from home, no Wacom. But that's okay. Now when I'm drawing, it doesn't really matter what colors you pick now, but it needs no fill and at any stroke. I'm gonna do three strokes, so I'm going to do yellow, green, and cyan, okay, for my three levels. Now when you're drawing, there's nothing to it. I'm gonna start from the outside in, it's totally up to you, but we're gonna draw all the way around. I'll show you what I mean. I'm gonna kind of draw around here, draw some loopy things, it's gonna come in and out. There's a lot of work that goes into kind of guessing what this is going to look like at the end, so we can do some adjustments later on. Cool, and you want to come back to the beginning. I shouldn't probably loop back on itself, but I'm sure it'll look fine. Cool, and you can see with the pencil tool up and smoothing, it made me look like I'm pretty good with my mouse here. All right, so that's the first level. I'm going to draw another one that is the green. Okay, and this one here is just gonna be like peeking in around this guy, in and out a little bit, but he's like kind of like the next level down that we saw in that intro video. You mean need to leave enough room, I guess, for whatever you decide how many levels you're gonna do. We did three in this case. Three plus the background equals four. Okay, and I'm just coming back to the beginning. All right, we'll speed this next bit up. I'm just gonna use blue, so let's go speedy version. All right, we're back. So that scribbly mess is, and this is the reason I picked the colors, I guess. Now we're gonna choose a set of colors to use for it. I'm gonna go to Window, Color Themes, just pick some colors, Color Themes. Okay, and if you go from Create to Explore, you'll get a bunch of colors. Mine's on most popular this month. Zoo is the one I'm gonna use. If you can't find it and you want to use it, just type in Zoo in search and you should be able to find them. Now, what we need now is four squares. Okay, for our four different levels, the three kind of squiggles plus the background. So draw a rectangle above the thing you wanna, you know, it just needs to be bigger. Doesn't really matter how much bigger. And we need to decide on the level. So I'm gonna start with orange and I'm gonna drag it up holding Alt and then hit Command D, D. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, zoom out. All right, so orange, blue, green, and pink. All right, so I've got these guys. Now I wanna lay these guys out on top of it. Let's do them in some sort of order. So I'll do this top one here. I'm gonna bring them to the front so that I can see them. Who was next? Green was next. Range, bring to front. You can right click them to bring them to the front. OK, Cool. And that guy just kind of fills in the background. So I've got these three. Now all I need to do is make them a compound path. Okay, you can go to Object, Compound Path, Make, or select them both and go Command 8 or Control 8 on a PC. Cool. Okay, so I've got my bits and pieces. Now I want to stack them on top of each other. So this can be a bit of a pain. Like, I want to put this guy up the top. This guy should be right down the back. So just keep playing with your layer order until you get something working. You really did not want to stick to that. I'm lining them all up, perfect. And that guy is at the back. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. So to give it the 3D kind of effect, what we're gonna do is have it selected, all of them, and we're gonna go to Effects, and we're gonna apply Stylize, and it's just a drop shadow. Okay, because it's a compound shape, so there's a hole in it, the drop shadow looks quite cool. Let's go preview. You can do inner glow and change the mode to normal and use black, but I want this kind of like 3D effect. So in here, it's just a matter of playing around, right? I've kind of played around with it already, and I was kind of happy with how it looked here. Maybe turn this down a bit. So it's just kind of a matter of playing around. Make sure preview's on. You can kind of see it's got its 3D-ness. Click OK. Now, another thing I like to do, well, when I was playing around, is I liked it when it had a second drop shadow that was just a little bit smaller. So I'll show you what I mean. You could leave it like this totally, because this next bit gets a little confusing. I want to add a second drop shadow. I'm going to close down the appearance panel. What I meant to do is go Effects, and let's go to Stylize and add drop shadow. And this is going to apply a second one. Okay, and I'm going to click it on, and it's going to freak out a bit. That's okay. We have to play around with the shadow order. So just take it from me at the moment. Just go leave it at 60. I'm going to do one by one by, I might turn this preview off. It's freaking out. One by one by two. Just kind of a really thin offset and not much blur. Reasonably strong. I might have to change that. Click OK. So we've applied the shadow, and it just doesn't work, right? It's applying a shadow on top of another shadow, which is, let's go to the appearance panel here. So there's two of them applied. Now what we need to do is just change this layer order, so I can drag this one underneath. And this is where sometimes it doesn't want to do it, right? So we have to do it individually, okay? Because they're all mixed appearances. So this is why, yeah, do you want to do it? So all I'm going to do is go to wireframe mode, which is view. And this top one here, Command Y or Control Y on a PC. I'm gonna click on my direct selection tool, click on this guy, and I'll drag him underneath. Where's the next line? That one there, drag him underneath. It's easy to do it individually. Not too hard, right? Cool. So that should be it. Let's go back out to wireframe mode or GPU preview. That's kind of what I was looking to do. I might have to change that setting. It's maybe a bit too dark around here. Let's click on it. And you can adjust them now. So was it the bottom one we want? Nope, the top one we want. Dan, get on with it. All right, it's the opacity that I'm gonna turn down. Click OK. It's kind of what I was looking, just a little bit more depth, is it? Maybe the blur's too big. I'm not gonna go change it because you wanna carry on. All you need to do now is clip it inside this. Okay, so I'm gonna grab my black arrow. Select this guy. I'll keep a version up there and drag it kind of roughly how we want. Make sure it's at the back of the X. Okay, get it kind of lined up and then select them all and then hit Command 7 or go up to, if you're on a PC, Control 7 or the long way, clipping mask, make, and we be 3D80s-ing. I think there's too much black on that shadow, but I'm gonna fix it afterwards. I'm not gonna keep you any longer, but now we've done it with curls. You can do it with spikes. You can do it with anything. It's just kind of basically compound shapes with a drop shadow. Gives you that kind of paper cut look. Now it's time for class exercise, okay? And it's going to be just doing a different letter with different blobs with different colors. You can use the same colors. I'd love to see it because it's such a cool, like it's pretty simple to do, kind of long, but you know, quite creative, I feel. So I'd love to see it if you could post it to us social media wise, Instagram, it's bring your own laptop, and Twitter is Dan Loves Adobe. Stick it on this site as well as a project. Okay, so take a screenshot, show me. I'd love to see it. Yeah, let's see what everybody makes. Cool, huh? All right, next video. Hey there, I hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up, it really helps out what I do. I've got lots of other stuff here on YouTube, so consider subscribing. Also, I wanna see what you made. Okay, so you're obviously doing something, don't be shy, I'd love to see what it is. If you're, if you put it up on Instagram, I'd love to, yeah, for you to mention me, I'm Bring Your Own Laptop on Instagram, and on Twitter, I'm Dan Loves Adobe. Also, if you like my teaching style and you know you want more advanced Illustrator stuff, there's the full course. Okay, it's on bringyourownlaptop.com. There'll be a link in the description. Also on Bring Your Own Laptop is there's a resources tab and there's a free cheat sheet in there. Free, totally downloadable. It has all the kind of, we did the keyboard shortcuts and stuff for Illustrator. It's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer. It's awesome. All right, continue on. Bye now.